So welcome to my presentation about the work done by the Sirius team for Sirius 3.1, which was just released last week and announced yesterday. So the title of the presentation is a kind of our punchline or catchphrase of what we want to achieve for each release, as we want to provide stronger, faster, and smarter diagram editors. So I am Maxime Porel. I work for Obeo, which is a French company focused on domain-specific modeling. We are 50 people working on products and projects on these technologies for customers or for Eclipse. We also provide services like training, consulting, and open innovation. I am a member of the Sirius team. I am a Sirius committer. And so for maybe some people do not know about it, but it is an Eclipse project which aims at providing specific multi-view modeling workbenches through diagram, trees, and table editors based on EMF. I will have three main topics in this presentation: how the tool is stronger in this version. How we made it faster and smarter. So first of all, the tool, we think that Sirius 3.1 is stronger than the previous version. The team has been, I think, very busy this year. We made a few releases between the 1.0 version release with Luna, and we have released the 3.0 version with Mars this year, with a lot of correction, improvement, and some feature requests. So to sum up, in June last year, the 1.0 version, October, Sirius 2, June 2005, Sirius 3, and last month or last week, Sirius 3.1. But don't panic. We have a simple way to upgrade or to help you change version of Sirius. The runtime will handle automatically handles the ODesign file, so the specification model and the IRD files, which are the representation file, that will be migrated for you at runtime. You have an easy process to change version. Just check the release note in the website or in the Eclipse help to see the user visible change. We also provide the specifier visible change and the developer's visible changes. Then you change your update site version if you are building products upon Sirius. In case of impacting API changes, you just have to recheck and follow our instructions in the release notes. And just note that eCore Tools and UML Designer had no impact to migrate from Sirius 1 to Sirius 2 or to Sirius 3. Sirius 3 or 3.1. There has maybe a few API breakage, but those are internal APIs, and the majority of APIs used by our customers are not impacted by our changes. We have some kind of different level of APIs. I will now speak about the different query languages you can use to define your modelers. In the specification tooling, you have a lot of different yellow fields, which are interpreted expressions. So Sirius will delegate to some interpreters or some query languages the expression, and those languages will be able to navigate your model or compute label for you or whatever you need. But in previous versions, it was not always easy to know which is the context of the interpretation, which kind of variable you have access to. So first of all, little come back on the available interpreters. You can use some feature interpreter. You directly access to EMF structural features. You can use service interpreter to access some Java code you provided, so Java extension you provided to Sirius. You also have a variable interpreter to directly access some variables. You have the MTL interpreter, which allow you to use some Axelos3 expressions, and the legacy interpreter to use a previous version of Axelio. And in this release, we introduce the AQL interpreter. I will speak about it later. It is a new interpreter specifically tailored for the Sirius needs. So the question you ask during some trainings, I think, is I have to write a target expression, for example, but I don't know on which element it will be calculated or computed. Now we have improved the completion, and if you, for example, use the var interpreter, it will propose you all available variables and the possible types. So for this example, it's an edge regression tool. It is linked to one or many edge mappings, which have one or many source mappings. So the tool will go through the edge mappings, looking at their type, and in this case, the source mappings are a man node mapping and a woman node, and we will retrieve that they are linked to or defined on man and woman concepts of the basic family metamodel. So we help you retrieve the, we help you by providing you the types. So you do not have to yourself go to your mapping definition and remember what you used. It is also available in the action language when you define the tool of your modeler. Sorry. Here I just create or called an operation to instantiate a basic family man. So the tool knows that if I use a navigation operation inside, the context of the evaluation will be a person, because it will be a man, but it will display you directly the feature available for a person, which is an abstract a superclass, and it will help you to directly to go faster. So to achieve that, Sirius requires stronger type information for interpreters. We made the reference support for this in AQL, which is the new interpreter. We have implemented the evolutions in the feature and var interpreter. We made some improvements in the Axelos3 interpreter, but the legacy and the OCL, which are less used, were not impacted by this change. So more and more, we are pushing users to use AQL. So I make a fast demo of the new capabilities of the VSM, the specification editor. During the presentation, you will see sometime a ribbon on the corner. It's for people coming after coming to look on the slide after the presentation to retrieve in which version we provide the new features, so they will be able to detect that the version they use have or not the feature. So I will present you the workspace class loading, the image path validation and selection, the quick outline, and the new submenus. So here I have a simple diagram based on the sample of the website. So it's a basic family metamodel. You have man, woman, you have father, mother links. And I want to do some changes on this diagram. So I have the specification model in my workspace. I am in live editing mode. I use the modeler I am designing to test it in live. So I can select, for example, this node. Because I am in live edition mode, I have the open definition menu, which will open the specification editor and put the selection on the mapping of the corresponding selection. So I want to use a Java service, because in Sirius you can extend or furnish Java services to do some complex computation. So here I defined I have defined a family services Java class. So it's very, very. No, it's not. I do not have the link with the editor. Okay, it's a very complex class. I would like to make some compute to call some compute label service. And so I have the getLabel service, which will return me computed label 4 and the name of a person. So I come back on my diagram. I want to modify the label of each man. So I open the definition. I can retrieve the style. I can go on the label property. And here, for the moment, it is the feature interpreter which is used and directly gets call the name feature of the basic family model. I want to use a service, so I call the service interpreter and I can use the completion to call my service, so which is deployed in live, and I can use my Java service to test my designer without being forced to deploy in a new runtime and manage several Eclipse runtimes.
I've got a question here. So Grandix makes those services that are applicable.
Yeah.
And also automatically additional arguments
I think that if you define services with some parameters, the completion will show you that you need parameters. So I save my VSMs, but my viewpoint specification model, and now on some man element, I can see that I retrieve directly the computed label. Some of them were not updated because there is some other customization specifically used for some of them. No, I would like to change the image to show you the new workspace image selection. So I go back on my VSM editor. I can use the quick code line. I want to retrieve elements using a SVG image. So I type SVG and I retrieve all elements. The quick code line show me that the search pattern was found in some workspace image path attribute, and it will help me to retrieve and to select the element I want to find. And so here I just want to change the image I use, so I can use the new selection wizard. It will show me all the images which are available in the workspace and also in the plugins, which has a lazy content provider, and I could expand all of them, but I do not need to. So I will find the animator.png image, for example, and if I come back on my diagram, I see that the image has changed. I have no bold people as image. I come back to my presentation. No, I just forget. The previous version of the specification editor only contained one menu to create new child in each element, and now we have created some prioritized menu. Depending on the context, and they will help you to directly choose what you want to add in the viewpoint specification editor. So, for example, if I am in a diagram description, I want to have the elements are well categorized, and so we provide you some help to define your specification faster. So now we'll go on the faster section. We wanted to improve the speed of the tool. So one of the goals to achieve that is to was to make some improvement and gain speed on big models. So the new target of the test we do for that was a 1 million model element as a model with 1 million elements as semantic model. And then when you add the representation model, you add diagrams, the GMF model, our internal models, and so you have a real set of elements which will contain a lot more than 1 million elements. We made constant improvement on the for big operation on those models. For example, for a huge project, we succeed to gain 30% in time during the opening and reduce the used heap by 20%. For the opening of a big class diagram, we reduce or divide per two the time to open the diagram. We lost some memory, but compared to the heap gain during the opening of the project, we are not at the same level, so it's still okay. We also gain time on refresh and save after diagram changes. And for the moment, close diagram and closing project take the same time, but those are additional aspects for later. So for the big operations, we have reduced the model footprints from about 20%. We now use minimally object as a root extend class during the EMF generation of our internal models. We also have transformed some e-object used by Sirius from e-object to immutable data types, which helps you save a lot of e-object creation. We have detected and corrected some leaks in the tool, and we also have reduced the usage of adapters and especially some content adapters. We also have modified our save strategy. The old one was to save in a temporary resource to detect if the concrete file changed, but they were targeting some specific use cases with clear case to avoid taking locks on specific files. And now the new default save strategy uses the resource status to know if a resource is modified, and it is and takes less time to save models. And we also made some improvements in the image cache, which was not really working as a cache, and so people using images on their diagrams might have encountered issues on previous versions. We also have worked on the latency, so the diagram refresh are faster, the UI runtime is more responsive. We used to have some issues on big diagrams when you use the contextual menu. For example, the delete menu used to do a lot of checks on the whole model, which were not required, and so we have improved the situation. And so now the contextual menu and some other actions do not depend anymore on the model size. We also have corrected the integration bridge with IF to provide better integration with Sirius and big models. We do not only improve the diagrams but also the tables. The refresh is also faster. The SWT control refresh is now done as a batch. So a lot of things around latency, around the big operations, and all of these things make the tool basically faster if you go from Sirius 2 to Sirius 3 or 3.1. But you also have another way to improve the responsivity of your tooling is to improve your of your designers, which is to write efficient queries And so for that, we now provide the Accelero Query language, which is a new interpreter, a new query language specifically tailored for the serious use case. So we have many variables for a given expression. You might have a null value everywhere during the navigation because you are on a model which have no value for one or one other reference. Then you have many steps in the navigation in which you are aggregating data, you filter collections, you navigate to another model, you do a lot of you can do a lot of stuff during the in the queries. And there is an interactive use of the query. For example, a query of a mapping will be evaluated on several elements. So the element type might change, the accessible variables might change, and the type of those accessible variables might also change. In Sirius, you also have the possibility to provide your own complex or custom logic through Java service. So a query language written for Sirius needs to be able to use those Java services. And we need a predictable ordering and a controlled performance override. So for the language characteristics, if you know OCL, then you will know AQL. If you know MTL, you will also know AQL with some little modification. There is no implicit variables. AQL.name will not is invalid because for AQL, it is a direct access to a variable name. If you want to access the name feature of an element, you have to call AQL self.name. If you use a select operation, it's the same. You cannot directly start by name. You need to create an iterator, name an iterator, and use it as context. So the completion will work and will recognize that. Here I have on e-content, so I can only know that it is on the object. But if here I use feature of a metamodel, I will be typed by the type of this feature. And something like self.reference with no value, dot something other attribute has no evaluation, some other attribute will produce no evaluation error. It will return nothing, but we will not have any error during the evaluation. This kind of requests written with the Accelero 3 interpreter will require you to call some OCL is invalid service or to always check that you are not on a null element. So with AQL, it's simpler. You just type self.myAttribute.myOtherAttribute. If one of them is null, the query will return nothing but without leveraging an error. And you will retrieve the classic operation, the filter, the collect, the select, and also convenient operation like inverse to retrieve the inverse cross references, so all the references in the model that are pointing to you, or the resource to retrieve the resource of an element. So AQL is not strictly compatible with MTL, but a subset of MTL will work for both. So if you know one, you will easily use the other one. Some characteristics about the implementation. It is very small, 100 class, non-generated. The evaluation is fast and collect errors as it goes. The validation is strong and precise. It will be called during the validation of the viewpoint specification editor. It has tiny dependency surface, so you might easily integrate to other tools and deploy it in other contexts. And we are compliant with the dynamic use cases, and it is extensible for simple Java classes. If you are on a specific domain, you might replace some services defined in AQL by your own implementation if you know you could do better. So a fast diagram, a diagram about the overhead bench. You can see in blue the interpreter dispatch. In red, the time to manage variables, and in yellow, the time spent to call external code or to evaluate the EOL content service of eCore. So we can see that Axel 3 is, and the legacy interpreter have the same amount of managing variable time. AQL service are better, and the big thing to do to see is that AQL service in AQL and service the service interpreter are way much faster than the I can say the old interpreters Axel 3 and Axelio 2. Yeah. I think this might come because AQL, the core of AQL is managing dependencies and barely know how to retrieve the Java classes, where maybe for the moment the service interpreter might need more work to find the way. I don't know the code of both interpreters, so I can. I think Selwig might help me. So AQL was released as an experimental feature with Sirius 3.0 and the Luna version, and it is now the recommended version for Sirius 3.1. In preference to Axelo 3 or OCL, it is simpler for querying EMF models, more concise and very easy to learn. You have an improved code completion, improved syntax error detection, and so you have to use it if you start on new if you start new projects. If you are still using the legacy interpreter, consider the migration from one to the other. If you are still using Axelo 3, you might begin to prepare your queries so that the upgrade will be easier. So avoid implicit context and maybe try to begin evaluating the change. I will skip the demo of a big model, and it was just to show that the UI is more responsive now. I will go to the other parts. The performance of a Sirius modeler also depends on you, because you write the queries. And so the performance might depend on your model topology, the query you use. You have to focus on which query might depend on the number of elements in the whole model. And you can measure, improve, and repeat those analysis phase during Sirius specification. There is a little time profiler view in Sirius. You just have to enable the preference and to open the view. And it will show you the time spent and the occurrences of each interpreted expression evaluation. So you will be able to maybe retrieve the expression which cost a lot of time and try to improve them step by step. Yeah. Yes, it is present from the beginning, I think. Yeah. No, I move on the smarter part of the presentation. So, first aspect is the diagram user experience. On diagram editor, you can often see some user with a grumpy cat face. So we did some work to try to reduce this the occurrences of selfies with this face. This was based on some user feedback. So one of them was some things about the resize in diagram editors. This is the old behavior based on GMF default behavior, because inside container the subnodes are relatively located. So when you resize when you resize a container, all its content will move, and the edge and all that stuff. And people generally want to avoid noise around their modification. So it was done for Sirius 2. Now the default behavior in Sirius is to resize only the current container, but keep all the other things in place. You can retrieve the old behavior with some keyboard shortcut, but this is the new behavior. We have also improved some positioning things in Sirius. The snap to shape is enabled by default for new diagrams. The snap to all shapes is available, so you are able to call the snap feature for elements which are not in the same containers. You have actions to distribute shapes regarding the space between them or between their center, and other actions. We also have improved the layouting of edge. Per default, all bend points are relative to the source and target, but in Sirius, we now only move the last segment when a node is moved. In previous version, there was also some instability with the edge label. Now, when you move an edge, the label will move consistently with the edge move. We have improved the link with editor. It's now bidirectional. When you select an element in a diagram editor, it will be selected in the model explorer. And when you select an element in the model explorer, the corresponding diagram element will be selected and revealed in the diagram editors. You have also the possibility to define that after a tool application, you want that specific elements be selected after the tool application. So you have some new, in all tools, you have some new interpreted expression to specify that behavior. We also help you to provide beautiful editors. This is a beautiful model. Sirius allows you to use workspace images. So this was the behavior with anchor borders and edge and connections through images. With Sirius 3, we now go to the first non-transparent pixel of your images, so you can provide much more accurate representation and more beautiful rendering. We also provide two new font formats, and underline and strike through, so you can define them in your editors, maybe to show that some element is invalid or something like that. We provide the possibility to define the border style. Before, this was only possible for the connection styles, but now it's possible for nodes and container borders. And we have released for Sirius 3 the possibility to define compartments in containers as experimental. It was an experimental feature in Sirius 3. You have the capability to define that you want to display subcontainers as an horizontal stack of compartments or as a vertical stack of compartments. A compartment is a standard mapping, so you can create fixed or dynamic number of compartments, and you just have to use the good queries to do that. With Sirius 3.1, the feature is complete. We have fixed some corner case around the rounded corners, the resize. So we have made a lot of polish for Sirius 3.1. We also provide the capability to collapse compartments. And just a few screenshots. A draft of eCore tools with compartments to separate attributes and operation, and just a more complex case in which compartments does not only contain list elements, but full containers. I skipped the demo because we are running out of time. So you have two new tutorials in the Sirius website, and one advanced tutorial and a specific tutorial to help you design your own compartments. First point about the roadmap for this year and next year. We made a lot of work. I spoke about that. For Sirius 3.1, I did not speak about first partial support for internationalization. All literal strings from the runtime have been externalized and are ready for internationalization. But it will. It might be completed maybe for in the future. So potential themes, themes for Eclipse Neon, better SVG rendering, preferred site for ports, customizable rich property views, and edition wizard. Maybe in some improvements around the internationalization, scalability, performance, headless, which can be on. Punchline for our release, we always want to improve all these aspects. And maybe your priority, if you have ideas or if you want that we provide open innovation and provide new features in the tool. Some takeaways. Sirius belongs to the state of the art modeling tools. You can just, okay. You can join the around 15 new authors every month on the Eclipse forum. And do not hesitate to download Hobo Designer Community Edition, which is a bundle containing Sirius, all its dependencies, and it's ready to use. And you have all what you need to begin and try and use Sirius. If you already use it, you can go on the bug 4484. It will be on the slides to provide us content, and we can add your content on the Sirius website. SiriusCon in December, the 3rd, in Paris. Talk from ETAS guy, from Sirius guys, from a lot of different people. The program, I don't know if it has been released or it will be done in today. Okay, so just go on SiriusCon.org. The slides are published on this site, but they are already available on the EclipseCon site. So do not forget to evaluate the session so I will be able to improve my skills. And so thank you. So, so no questions because Kai already took all the time. But we will be available at the next.